this video, which is follow the last video, we still talking about the 春秋, 战国时期, because I want you guys figure out clear about what year representative. 年代表, in Chinese, we say 年代表, year representative. 年代表, 年代表. 那春秋战国时期是中国的一个 一个朝代, 一个什么朝代? 我们的朝代, dynasty, OK. 周 dynasty, almost over done finished. 周 dynasty, OK. 周 dynasty almost finished. You can say 春秋战国时代, it's a 周 dynasty, OK. Or you just only say 春秋战国时代 or 春秋战国时期. Both, they work. If I say 春秋战国时期, I prefer say this part. If I say 春秋战国时期 from the Zhou dynasty, that means Zhou almost over done finished, the end, they have this part, 春秋战国时期. Okay, why we say this one? Because they have a lot of hero, 英雄. Because they have a lot of big person, 了不起的人, 大人物. For example, 孔子, 孟子, 老子, 庄子, 韩非子. Wow, huge, a lot. Yeah, that's why we need to figure out this part here, okay? So then this is complicated about the Chinese the history. It depends. If we figure out, it is not complicated, just difficult to remember. Yeah, it's complicated, right? Okay, so let's figure out where we are. Okay, where we are. 春秋战国时期, we can say the end Zhou dynasty. Okay, Zhou dynasty in Chinese, we say what? Zhou, which follow the sound, dynasty, we say Chao, Zhou Chao. Okay, Zhou Chao, I don't have this one here, I don't have. 周朝, Zhou dynasty. Zhou dynasty is the beginning? No. Before Zhou dynasty, we say 商朝, 商店的商, 商人的商, business person, 商店, store, some character, okay? Some character. We say 商 dynasty, and 商 before 夏 dynasty. And that's it. See, look, that's too easy, right? 夏 dynasty, 夏. 夏天的夏, somebody may be last name, 姓夏的夏, 夏 dynasty, then before, no, 夏 is start, beginning, for Chinese the dynasty, again, careful, I say what, I say dynasty, 朝代, 朝代, what do you say, dynasty, I say 朝代, right, then you say 朝, dynasty, translation, we say 朝代, When we say, what dynasty? We say, 夏朝. We don't like to say, we don't like to say, 夏朝代. The dynasty, when we plus the name, we drop the 代. We just only say, 朝. We say, 夏朝. We don't say, 夏朝代. You can, but Chinese, they don't say that here. Why? Because common, informal, 朝代 is dynasty. When we say with the name 夏, what dynasty? 夏 dynasty. We only say 夏朝. We don't like to say 夏朝代. We just dropped 代. Because in that case, we know 朝, which means 朝代 from the dynasty. We can drop it. When before we learn in Japan, right? Japan in Chinese, we say 日本. Do you hear Chinese, they say 日本国, maybe somewhere, but not really common, okay? We local person, we say 日本, because we know Japan, it is a country, we don't have to plus the 国, well, okay? We just say 日本, we don't have the 日本国, when you say 日本国, wow, they work, but so formal, we like to say very common words, right? 日本, and that's it, something here, okay? 朝代, we say 朝代, dynasty. Then when we say 朝代, we don't like to say, if with the words, with the name, we only say 夏朝. We don't like to say whole name. 下朝代。Okay, then that's it. Okay, 夏朝 is in Chinese the history as the first dynasty. If you want to, you can remember that before Christ. Before Christ, we say what? 公元前 in Chinese. 前 that's easy, right? 前 is before Christ. Chinese, we say 公元 but exactly translates again what? 主 or 基督 Okay, here. 公元前2070年哇2070年 is start beginning in Chinese the first dynasty 夏朝 and that's it we're okay here why say that I want to figure out the follow back here when you say year representative I want you to figure out here year representative in Chinese we say 年代表 then you know that's 年代表 Chinese the first dynasty夏朝 look here 夏朝 then 夏朝 what year 2070 before Christ and until 2070 呢 after Christ right now it's 2020 4090 yearsStories, hey, stories, 历史 OK. 2070年夏 dynasty, then that's it, we're okay here. Then after 夏, we're back here. After 夏, because 夏 is the first dynasty. After 夏, we're back, 商 dynasty. 商人的商 basement person, 商 商 store, 商店的商 商 dynasty, OK. After 商 dynasty,Zhou Dynasty. Okay. After Zhou Dynasty, almost all done finished, they have the special part. We say, 春秋战国时期. Why say 春秋战国时期? And sometimes say 春秋战国时期, still can be say Zhou Dynasty. Because if you say Zhou Dynasty, they are Zhou Dynasty. But Zhou is the king in Chinese. We say,大王国王 he don't have power nobody listen to them nobody listen to him okay so then that's why we can say 问春秋战国时期 this part they want to say they are independent you can say they are independent however you say I am from the end Zhou dynasty but we can say we areWhat? Independent. Okay. 独立的。独立的 is a part. That's why I say you can say both. You can say, you want to say the Zhou Dynasty covered 春秋战国时期 they work? Yeah, they work. Okay. They from there, the end Zhou Dynasty. You say, no, that's right, because they are independent. It's 独立的。独立 they don't follow 夏 king. Not follow, they don't.Listen to them. Okay, the Xia king don't have power. Okay, finally, we're back here again. Okay, we overdone finished before the year representative. 年代表 Now we can talk about the 孔子、孟子、老子、庄子 or 韩非子. We can't say a lot here in this video.But we can see them. Finally, so happy that because they are really famous, then you really know who is Kong Zi again. We review Kong Zi again. Okay, review Kong Zi again. Okay, Kong Zi, I say Kong Zi have a lot of 72, right? The final numbers, 72. Okay, Kong Zi 有很多学生，三千多学生。Before 学生 we don't say 学生 we don't say 学生 say what?所以弟子孔子弟子三千七十二贤子 What do they say here? 孔子弟子三千弟子 is student, right? 孔子有三千 no, 三千 more 三千多名学生最优秀的最好的最贤能的贤能的贤能是指 最好的，贤能是最好的，最好的这个 quality and smart and study, you know, hard worker, just nice person, okay. In that case, nice person means really like to study, okay, study, because 孔子 is a teacher, 弟子 is a 学生, okay. 有七十二个最有贤能的，贤能的 remember, when they say someone, 他很有贤能 means they are smart, they know everything, okay. And also, it's a nice person.孔子有七十二个最好的学生 ，OK。那孔子出生的时候，他的爸爸七十二岁。孔子 on the life how old？ 七十二 ，OK。She look， 孔子 keep three， 七十二。On life seventy-two。Is when he's born his father 七十二。那 he have seventy-two 最好的学生。OK here， 七十二。We just talking about 孔子 Now sometimes you say, oh, YINGYING, when they say 孔子, they always say 孔孟孔孟孔孟 means 孟子孔老先生孟老先生 They got, they both friends, students, teacher and student. Okay. 孔孟 I don't say 孟孔, right? I like to say 孔孟 I don't say 孟孔 I say 孔孟 That means 孔子 before 孟子 after 孟子是孔子的 what 学生，孟子是孔子的学生哦。The 孟子 teach 孔子啊。Answer yes or no. I want to say no. If you say no, how you say 孟子 is a 孔子的学生 ？The case here. 孟子 OK. The 孟子的 teacher 孟子的老师是孔子的 what？Grandson, what means grandson? Grandson is in Chinese, we say 孙子 孙子 okay. Another 孙子 okay. We have another 孙子兵法 right? We talk a little. This is 孙子 means grandson. You know that, right? If you are son, then if you have a son, right? Then your son is your father's grandson. Okay. 孟子的老师是孔子的 grandson.And also, 孟子 still say 孔子 is my teacher. They work? Yes, they work, okay? 那孔子的孙子 grandson 是谁的学生？曾子。Too much. You don't have to remember. 曾子，曾子 the person name. 曾子是谁？曾子是孔子的学生。And that's why. And that's why 孟子 can say, see?孔子 is my teacher. Again, 孔子的学生叫曾子。曾子的学生叫是孔子的孙子。孔子的孙子是孔子的孙子是孟子的老师。所以说孟子 so 孟子是孔子的学生。They work. Okay, definitely they work. Yes. The,孔子有很多学生 3,000 三千多 Why they just say 孔孟 Why they don't say 孔 somebody else 在上面是孟子是孔子最好的学生里的一个最好的学生那说一下那孔子是什么思想 We know this one 儒家思想孔子的思想我们给他起个名字叫儒家思想儒 is a funny word 儒家思想 why? It's a funny why see this one when you're learning Chinese maybe after you want to test or so some things that's easy to remember okay, then easy to understand okay, then that's why I say 孔子 have a 372 then you can remember that and also I say 孔子的思想 we give the name we say儒家思想，儒家思想，孔子是什么地方的人？儒国人。Pronounce is the same. 儒家思想，儒国人。Character different, okay? Character different, okay? 孔子是儒国人。儒国是现在的什么地方？山东曲阜。山东曲阜，山东曲阜。 那孔子还总会喜欢说他是什么呢？他是舜国人。舜国 is background, is grandfather. His grandfather is 舜国 king 的 brother. And that's it. That means he wants to say descendants of a king. His background, his family tree is the descendants of the king. Okay, here, and that's from where? From to the 舜。他的第十四代爷爷代 we already say that 一代 you from your parents 一代 your grandfather from your parents and you 两代那第十四代 14 第十四代的爷爷是宋国的 king 的 brother 大王国王的 brother 哥哥 or 弟 OK here and that's why he want to say thatAfter, we already see that in the last video, I already explained that, okay? Then he already had another grandfather, right? 孔父家, he is still his grandfather, 第六代爷爷, okay? Somebody killed. Then his father is nervous, they killed his father, right? His father is what? It's a 叔良鹤, the word is somebody killed big family. Then they just move.从宋国来到了鲁国，那孔子 is 鲁国人。We okay here? Okay. We finished. Let's talk about the 孟子。孟子 we already finished. We already figured out. Okay. 孟子，孔子，孟子，孟子是孔子的学生，所以他们的思想、他们的想法是一样的。都是什么想法？都是儒家思想，都是儒家思想。Why we say 孟子 Because 孟子 is 把孔子的儒家思想变得更好更好 OK 孟子 Then after 孟子 We can compare it We have a lot people there right Then before I want to say one story here From to who Why say that Then you say Why we always say 孔子 so smartAnd Kunzi really like to study. Can we see, for example, the answer? Yes. Okay, have a story. The title we say, 孔子学琴。孔子学琴。You know, 我们的琴 play the music. Okay, 孔子学琴。那孔子什么时候学琴呢？多大开始学琴呢？孔子五十岁的时候。五十 ，You know, 五十 fifty.50 age years old. Even right now, somebody 50 years old started to play, to study the music. It's not really young, right? Not really young. We have to think. It's a long time ago, right? A long time ago. Okay, very long, right? Very long. Okay, we have to remember that, right? Long time ago. We can see...春秋战国时期 is very very long time ago there. 孔子五十岁的时候开始学琴。学琴的时候我们要想那我们现在学琴的时候会有一个 menu 叫琴谱。We say the menu when we go to the restaurant, right? 叫菜谱菜单 right? How the menu, we can see, oh, I like this one, I like that. This one we say something, the 谱 menu, 菜谱。食谱菜单那 play 咱们 music we say 琴谱 it means when you play something how to read then you can play the music right before long time ago we don't have that if we don't have that how we learn the teacher they just tell that the teacher they just say that maybe teacher to sing the student how to figure out how to think and to follow okay那孔子学琴，老师教孔子。孔子学琴学了好长时间，学了一段时间。老师说：“孔子，你的琴不错，非常好。” Maybe you say, "A piano? It's not piano, okay? It's not piano, okay? What 琴 ？Chinese we say 古琴 ，It's 中国很老很老以前的琴 ，just a wood have two lines or three lines, just keep it there, then can just play, right? 那以前弹琴不是给别人听 Don't want somebody listening, right? Then for who? 给自己听 Why not? Because I think, okay, it's very quiet, 声音很小很轻别人听不见因为是古琴以前的琴很老对吧现在的琴很多人都可以听见以前 not, OK 是给自己听所以你要 have the feeling, have the figure out, have the thing, what is the meaning 那孔子学琴老师就教他告诉他应该这样应该这样怎样弹是怎样怎么样一个声音用嘴去讲 explain 孔子听了以后哦就弹他说哦 you're right 你对了你弹得非常好第一次学琴的时候老师就会教学生你弹吧、啊、学生 homework 孔子就开始练习练习练习 after a couple days few days 过了几天老师回来了 second time 说孔子我想看看你弹的琴怎么样啊孔子呢就给老师弹琴老师一听哦 super great 太好了不错你的琴弹得非常非常的好你可以学一个新的曲子的 another music 可以学一个新的琴 新的曲子孔子就非常非常谦虚地说老师我可不可以你可不可以你能不能可以不可以再给我一点时间再让我练习练习老师就会说为什么呢为什么这要练习一下呢他说因为我会了但是我觉得我不够熟练不够 flexible、okay? 不够灵活不够、啊、还不够好他说那好吧那如果你喜欢的话你可以再练习一下我过几天再来 you can practice 你可以再练习一下孔子又开始练习又开始练习弹又过了一段时间 Time so fast, right? You like the time fly, the fast 老师又回来了第二声老师你孔子请你弹一下琴我听一听你弹的怎么样了孔子就弹琴老师哦你弹的真的非常非常的好孔子说嗯我也觉得不错孔子不谦虚的反正很谦虚我也觉得挺好的我觉得我会弹了但是我也觉得我也比较熟练了、啊、比较弹的手指都比较舒服比较熟练了可是老师说你得学新曲子了 How to study to learn another one, new one 可是说老师能不能再让我练习一下我们学老师快给我一个新的吧孔子没有老师能不能再让我练习一下再让我学一下老师说为什么呢他说我要感觉一下 have a feeling 我要 figure out I want to figure out what is meaning 弹琴他要 enjoy 一下我要弹我会我弹的也很舒服可是我不知道他的意思 the meaning 是我要感觉一下 want a feeling that want to figure out 是什么意思 what is meaning 老师一看孔子太聪明了太喜欢学习了老师说那行吧那好吧你继续练习吧孔子又开始练习又练了好长好长一段时间练了好长时间老师又回来老师说孔子你这次怎么样啦孔子说啊我觉得这次练得不错我觉得我明白它是什么意思了我理解他是什么意思了可是老师我觉得我弹的也很好我弹的也很舒服我也明白他的意思了但是老师我想再感觉一下他说啊你还要感 want a feeling feeling what 我想感觉这个曲子是谁写的曲子 who write this music 谁写的曲子我先感觉一下 Right now we like ask who right No before the teacher, they're not talking to the students. 孔子的老师没有告诉孔子。孔子说，老师，我想感觉一下，写这个曲子的人是谁，是什么意思？我可以感觉 that from my feeling. I want to figure out 写这个音乐这个曲子，曲子就是 play this, not play the, to write this music, to write this music, the feeling. 我想感觉一下。老师听了以后非常非常的高兴，说好吧，我再给你时间，我过几天再来。孔子又开始一次一次一次又一次的练习弹琴。过了几天，老师来了，老师就问孔子，这一次怎么样啊？你的琴练得怎么样啊？孔子特别高兴，说老师，我这一次知道是谁的曲子了，我觉得我明白他的意思了，他是一个非常了不起的 big leader, big king, big king, 周文王写的曲子，是周文王写的曲子。老师非常非常的惊讶，为什么？ The teacher talking 孔子。 No, he don't talking 孔子, 孔子 don't know, 孔子 know nothing, 孔子 know what, teacher just teach him, teach 孔子 how can play the music, then that's it. Teacher taught the meaning, no.Teacher taught them who to write this music? No. Teacher taught nothing. Teacher teach 孔子 how can play that? Then that's it. 孔子说，我明白他是什么意思了，我也知道这是谁写的曲子。孔子就告诉了老师，请问这个曲子是不是了不起的 The Big King 周文王写的？老师说，对，你怎么知道的？他说，我弹这个曲子的时候 play this music, I just want to try the feeling. 我感觉这个曲子一定是一个 king, 一定是一个了不起的周文王写的。周文王是一个心怀天下，什么意思？是 just a big heart, it is a big heart. 周文王是有一个大心的人，心怀天下 again, 天下 is a country.心 is a heart, 心怀 that the sin, big heart can cover whole country, 就是 big heart, it means big heart. 他是一个心怀天下的人，老师非常高兴。那讲这个故事呢，孔子学琴是讲孔子是一个非常好学的人，孔子也是一个非常非常聪明的人，非常聪明，五十岁的时候还在开始学习，还在开始学习，而且学琴。学习的时候非常非常的认真，非常努力，非常好。刚才我说了一个周文王， Now you can see here, I want to review again. 周文王，周 is 周 dynasty. 文王 is a king, is 大王，周文王。那就是说因为那个时候是周 dynasty, right?春秋战国时期 over done finished 周 dynasty just 春秋战国 那一段时间是 what we can say independent 是非常独立的。 You can say they are from the 周 dynasty or you can say just 春秋战国时期 independent. If you say they are independent, you say 春秋战国时期。If you don't want to prefer say they are independent, you can say 周 dynasty, 周朝末 almost over than finished. Both they were. Chinese lesson. In the depends, if they ask for the dynasty, 春秋战国时期 from the 周. And that's why she looked, 孔子 say 周文王. That means he's from there. He's from there. We're okay here?那我们讲的是这个是孔子，别忘了孔子还有一本书叫《论语》。《论语》这本书你可能听过，《论语》啊，《论语》孔子有一本书，这本书是关于孔子的，应该这样说啊。 那是不是孔子写的吗？ Difficult to say. No, 不是。那这本书写的是什么？写的是孔子和学生说的话。我们现在看一本书都是一个 story, 一个 article, 一个 article, right? Or just a story, right? 我们可以看，哦，非常 interesting, 有意思。那论语是不是呢？ No. Finally, answer means no.论语是一个什么书呢？论语是孔子的学生给论语是孔子的学生写的一本书，叫给的名字 The name we say 论语 Look here. 那论语里面写的是什么呢？ About 孔子 right? About 孔子的思想，儒家思想，就孔子的一些想法，孔子在教学生的想法，就是论语，写在论语里面，在论语里面。Also, 论语里面还有什么呢？孔子说的话，比如说就是 answer what? Then from the students ask questions, then 孔子 answer. Student ask a question, 孔子学生问，老师答，学生问，老师答。三堂问为 read, that's confused. Yeah, that's confused.From where? We don't know from where. Just one sentence. One sentence. Questions, answer. Questions, answer. Or sometimes only 孔子 say some things. It's 孔子的 idea. 他的思想就是他的想法。他的想法。Okay, here? 那孔子的想法 is totally different than not a big person. For example, 老子的想法 different. And that's why we give 孔子的想法the name, the 思想 say,儒家思想，儒家思想 ，because they think different, right? We give the name 儒家思想。孔子是儒家思想的创始人，这名字。孔子 build this 思想 ，OK? 孔子是第一个有的这样的思想，这叫儒家思想。那孟子呢，是把孔子的儒家思想变得怎么样啊？更好。And that's why we like to say 孔孟 We not say somebody else, right? We like to say 孔孟 However, 孔子有很多学生 right? We like to say 孔孟 We not say another student Because 孟子给他的老师孔子的思想变得更好 And that's why when we say 儒 Absolutely, 孟子 is 儒家思想 right? That's why we say 儒家思想 We like to say 孔孟 little guy here. And 论语 we know that 论语 we just talking about the 孔子的思想儒家思想就孔子的一些想法 in that book. 论语就是 the name for the book's name. And 里面就是 the book we talking about 老师 answer 学生的 question. We can talk later a lot here. We okay for here? Okay. Now we can see the another as a bigger person. Maybe you're really want to know, right? 儒家思想 Also, they have the different 思想道家思想 Maybe you know that. So, no, I don't. Okay, you don't know 道家思想 But I think when you know who is 老子 Maybe yes, maybe no. 老子 okay, 老子 is still a very, very famous, very big person, very smart, okay?那孔子的想法我们叫儒家思想那老子的想法我们叫什么呢叫道家思想 because totally they are different 孔子讲礼仪讲道德 OK 人应该怎样做应该怎样守规矩应该怎样讲道德应该怎样讲礼貌这是孔子的儒家思想道家思想人应该怎样顺其自然要听从大自然的大自然是什么样的我们要跟着大自然所以他们两个的思想 totally different Then, now it's a question who is a 老子 from where that's why I want to say 春秋战国 this part 还有 lot of hero 英雄Have a lot of 人才 smart person, a big person. 很多很多很多。 那老子呢？老子是什么时候？老子是春秋时候。孔子呢？孔子 both 春秋战国 ，right？ 孔子 burns 春秋 ，death is 战国。能 that's why we like say 春秋战国 together。那 also this term the short time， OK？ We like put together， OK？ 春秋战国时期，老子呢 from to the 战国，能 when his death。We don't know. Maybe what that cool person they last name is Lao, right? No, no, that's not last name, okay? But we still not even in Chinese, we still not really figure out who is that person. We don't know who's that person. How we talk about that? It's a lot of funny things here, okay? Then somebody maybe say, oh, that person seeing something, right? Okay.We want to figure out how we talk about the 老子 okay? 老子的思想 now we talk about 老子的思想 we say 道家思想儒家道家 okay? Different, right? 孔子 we can stop or finish here, okay? We talking a lot of 孔子 we can back again after, okay? So now we talk about 道家的第一个人是老子 again, 老子不姓老姓什么 we now figure out okay so just 那老 what means 老 old 老子 old master that's okay 老子 right now 这个子 is master okay old master means that person is more old but so smart he's so smart okay he's live in a 战国 that's term 战国时期战国时期他非常非常的聪明，他说了很多很多了不起的话。Again, we have to figure out here. 了不起的话，以前学东西。Do you remember when I say 孔子学琴？孔子 how to read some things? 孔子 how to follow some things? No. Before we learn something, we say 口口相传。Yeah. Finally, we use the 口 right? What means 口 ？Mouth, 嘴。嘴 that's why we say 口 right 嘴、okay. 口口相传口口相传意思means 用嘴去教 do you have a book no we don't have a book before right just talking、okay. 用嘴去说口口相传用嘴去讲用嘴去说那那个时候有一个老人 means they are long time on the life 老人 old person old Mr. 老子Okay, we say 老子 because they are really smart. Okay, 老子一个老人非常非常的聪明，他的思想、他的想法都非常的好，很多人都喜欢。How you know? 他讲，他告诉别人，他说我们应该听自然的，跟大自然的规律走。人很多人喜欢他，很多人喜欢他，可是呢？他很老很老的时候呢死了当他死了的时候这个时候我们不知道 we don't know when he dies okay 我们不知道 but we know we have this person as a very old master he's very smart we just say 老子那 the time flies 到了春 over finished 春秋 finish 到了战国 after 春秋 after 春秋就是战国战国时候这一段时候是 some young people some young bunch people some bunch people 是 younger OK 他们呢非常他们就是这个 old master 的 fans 粉丝 How? Because 他们就听说 they hear 听说他非常聪明听说他非常聪明也知道他说过很多话说过什么什么什么什么话 We can for example later OK说过很多话所以就把他说的话 Remember we talk about the 论语 right? Okay, 论语 talking who? 孔子 Now they say this one, this bunch of people bunch of people okay, they like who? 孔子 No They are like 老子 Okay, because they totally different 儒家道家 okay, 他们特别喜欢老子讲的话把老子说的话写在一本书上 Okay, finally, we're done, finished. We need to give the name, right? 这本书写好了 from the old guy, old master. So we say, what the name? Okay, so now we say, maybe create the name, say, Laozi. Okay, okay, now we knock here, right? 这个书的名字叫 Laozi. Okay, 书里写的就是一个 old master 说的话。Who wrote this book? Some young people, bunch of people, maybe two, maybe three, maybe five. Just some young people, the fans. Who's the fans? Okay, 这是 fans from to who? The old master. 这些人是这个老先生老子的 fans, 粉丝特别喜欢他。老子他们把老子说的话写了一本书，书的名字就叫老子。They work, they say, who wrote these books? We don't know, just some people. Some people say one, some people say two. I prefer for the bunch young people, okay? Definitely not one, okay? Maybe three, maybe four, maybe five. 这些人非常喜欢老子，把老子说的话写在书上，给他的名字就叫老子。Okay, 老子 and 孔子They are almost the same, right? Both from the 春秋战国时期. We compare. 孔子 study. 对应说上孔子没有老师. 孔子 study from where? From by himself. He's by himself, okay? 他自己学,自己看,自己想,孔子. 老子呢?老子据听说听说 I hear from somewhere 老子这个 old master have something know something from to who from himself no he have a t-shirt and that's why for example here 他的 t-shirt 叫什么呢他的老师叫什么呢叫商容商容商店的商商朝的商商人的商容容易的容商容商容这个人呢是老子的一个老师在中国很早很早以前老师就像自己的 parents 一样就像自己的父母一样要对父母特别的尊敬我们知道尊敬就是礼貌客气所以学生对老师非常非常的尊敬非常非常的客气有礼貌这个老子我们不知道他的名字 We just know this old master We just say he's a 老子 Right? Okay Now he still have a teacher His teacher is a 商容这个老子啊对他的老师非常非常的好非常好说但是呢他的老师一点一点的老了身体呢有一点一点的病了 OK 后来呢 after 越来越重越来越严重 almost died not yet OK 非常非常重要死了这个老子啊就非常的伤心 sad 难过 OK 伤心难过他非常爱他的老师他说老师啊老师他说如果你要 if you are not on life it's dead 死了我怎么办呢 I learn from to who 我和谁学习呢你能不能多告诉我一点多让我多学一点多知道一点事情 After you when you die 当你死了的时候我应该怎么做呢 OK 那他的老师商容躺在床上 Lay down on the back非常非常的病就告诉这个老子当然老子要在老师的身边商人的身边就对他特别好可能给他做饭啊可能给他拿水呀、啊、来照顾他这一切这真是非常非常的好非常好他就问说老师您能不能告诉我几句话 Tell me some things before you died 这个商人啊就跟这个老子就说我想告诉你当你坐车的时候到家门口的时候 don't forget, 别忘了下车。啊，下车什么意思啊？就是 get out, 下车。这个老子特别聪明啊，他就明白了。老师，您的意思是说让我别忘了我的老家吗？啊 ，don't forget my hometown people, right? 中文为啥是别忘本，别忘别忘，忘是 forgot, 别 do not, don't forget your background, your hometown, 别忘了老家，什么意思 ？Don't forget that, 意思是 OK here. 再说一遍 here. 当你坐车的时候。当你坐车到家门的时候，路过家门的时候，经由家门的时候，别忘了 stop there, get out. 也就是 there is something else here. 有些车 is China, Chinese, China, they have the car before long time ago. I'm saying you're smart. You know they don't. We have a car, 车 is different, okay? It's different. We can say 马车。Okay, or I can say somebody keep. Okay, so 车. Okay, now I think you understand here, right? It's not right now, it's right now the car, okay? The traffic. No, it's different, okay? From the house, they from the wood, they make the box. Or maybe just from the people, they take them and some people sit down in the center there. Just wood center there. Okay, anyway, now 车, we're just talking about 车 here, okay? So the 意思是说那老子的是 become a bigger person, right? The rich, because 老子 smart, right? Because 老子 learning, after 老子 was rich, right? The big person, right? 那意思是老子啊，等我这个，等你有钱的时候，等你做官的时候，坐车的时候，能坐车，普通人不能， right? Even from before long time ago, okay? Definitely 有钱的人，读书人，聪明人。这当官的人，等你坐车的时候，别在家门口的时候，在家门前走的时候 ，don't forget, OK? When you 坐你的车，在你过你家附近的时候，别忘了 ，don't forget, get out, 下车。那老子就说：“老师，您的意思是让我别忘本吗？别忘本 ，don't forget, 本是 before, OK? Before from where, OK?本是本来原来的意思本那就是 in that case means your hometown okay? background 别忘本意思是 you have, however you are a big leader 你是大官 however you're so rich don't forget your hometown people okay? don't forget your hometown you're from there always remember 老子说老师我明白了我一定会记住的意思是不管我 ，However, I'm a big person. I'm rich. I still I have memory where I from. Okay. 那为什么老师的 teacher 商荣 just say, "Don't forget, get out, 下车"？老子就明白呢 ？Because they understand each other. Because 老子非常非常的爱他的老师。老子非常的聪明，老师说什么他都能听懂。OK, here, then finish. No, 老师又说了。第二件事呢？当然，老子又，老师还有没有一句话 ？Can you give me another one? Can you say another sentences? 老师还有没有一句话？再告诉我一下。我们想，商荣 is really sick, right? We're very sick. 他说，好吧，我可以。再告诉你一句话，要死了 ，almost died， 就是要死了，非常非常。这商荣呢，因为老子太喜欢学了，商荣看老子喜欢学，那商荣当然喜欢老子了，他一定会告诉他。商荣又说了，说当你走在一个非常 huge or big the tree， 走在树的下面的是 under the tree， right？在树下面走的时候别忘了一定要屈行什么是屈行啊就不要这样直着走要这样弯着走要身体是弯着走 OK 要弯下来走矮一点走什么意思叫屈行这个商荣老子的老师就是告诉老子说你走到什么时候呢你平时走路的时候要这样直直的 straight right 直直的 但是走在一棵大的树的时候 big and huge and old 树的时候，你要屈行，把你的身体弯下来弯下来弯下来，这样走啊，就是不能觉得你自己很高，你要矮一点走。这个老子特别聪明，说老师您的意思是说让我孝顺父母对吗？非常非常聪明。那商容非常高兴，点点头，对了，你说对了，意思就是不管你 however you're rich however you're a big person， 不管你是有钱，不管你是一个多大的一个大官，你一定要怎么样啊？对你的父母好，对年长的人好。什么年长？ old person old people， 对老人好，对父母好。看到老人的时候，就是 for example the big tree right old big tree， 你要弯下腰来走，要有礼貌孝敬他们，孝顺孝敬父母。孝顺孝敬以前我讲过 OK， 孝顺孝敬就是听从服从爸爸妈妈说的话，对爸爸妈妈有礼貌。在中国人喜欢说叫孝顺，顺是顺着听的意思，孝是礼貌的意思，孝顺孝敬都可以。那老子说谢谢谢谢老师，那伤容已经非常非常的病非常严重。这老子非常聪明啊，非常非常喜欢学。说老师老师，能不能求求你啊，再告诉我，再教我一点更多的东西呢？能不能再告诉我一句话呢？再给我讲一点呢？他的老师商容又说了一句，又说了一句什么话呢？就是老师说，你看我已经很病了，啊，我已经很老了，我马上就要死了。你看看我的嘴，这个老师也很奇怪，为什么老师让我看他的嘴啊？那就看一下吧，嘴是嘴，这口 mouth 嘴，你看一下我的嘴，你看到了什么？老子说，我看到了舌头 tongue 舌头，还看到了什么？老子说 nothing 什么也没有 nothing 什么也没有。And something else. How about tooth? Tooth? Teeth, tooth. Hey, 老子, yes, no, no, 商容 don't have that. 牙齿没有牙。And that's why, 是, 老子 say something tooth. I only see the teacher, 商容. Not me, 商容, okay? I have this, right? 商容. The mouth only have a tongue. The tongue. Then tooth, no.没有牙，商容就 for example， 所以你看，什么最坚强啊？一个人很老的时候，什么最坚强啊？牙齿坚强，牙齿有没有啊？没有了，舌头呢？柔软，弱软软 soft 弱，有没有啊？有，那什么意思呢？所以你生活的时候 under life 的时候。你想 on long time on life, okay? Maybe you don't try that out here, but we have to know this one from the long, long time ago. Long time ago, they just say that, okay? So, 你想要 long time on the life, right? 有的时候你要 you have to know how to care yourself, 要小心照顾自己，就像舌头一样柔软一点，弱一点，然后很壮，这个意思。那老子又问老师还有没有啊，还有没有啊？商容说 The three sentences is on your life good enough 够了，足够了，你记住这三句话你就都会了，这个就是你的生活，你就会了。那这里讲了一个非常非常好玩的事儿。那在这里的意思就是道家的思想讲什么呢？讲柔弱，很弱。有一句话叫柔弱胜刚强， this is difficult to understand that. Okay, you can for example, 我们可以说一个水，水 is strong and hard. 水 is not, 水 is not strong, 水 is more sharp, right? 如果你把水你可以放在 box, 你可以放在盒子里头， 你也可以放在碗里面，你也可以放在什么地方。水是非常 soft， 水是非常软的，非常弱的 ，weird and soft。那石头呢？石头是石头很硬，对吧？石头很硬，可是呢，很少很少的水可以把石头穿透， right？ 那水是很弱，但是它可以穿透，穿透看 through， right？ 穿透石头，所以通常我们会说，很软的东西可以打败、击败很弱的东西。That's I say here. Okay, we can talk about next time. Bye for now.